Good afternoon. Let me introduce myself. My name is Giulio Vivo. I'm from Centro Ricerche Fiat, the world-class manufacturing research and innovation department. And first of all, I would like to thank you to Marek, to Ilan, and to Patrizia for the opportunity given to us to present our work in Medifor, which is related to the digital twinning and to the application of these simulation methodologies to the building energy modeling. Let me start my presentation. One second, please. Okay, I hope you can see my screen. Let put me in my widescreen mode. Okay, so as you can see here, there is a summary of the activities we are doing, and basically at the end of the first year of activities, we completed the data collection for the data for the digitalization and modeling, and we have let's say built and run a first model of the digital twinning model. Clearly, the objective is the one of developing this digital twinning model on a given use case, which is represented by the paint shop area. It's a very large industrial settlement in the context of the Mirafiori settlement in Turin. So let's move on. Okay, as you can see, the digital twin is a copy, is a virtual model of a real object. This is something that is in the experience of all people who is working on Industry 4.0 or similar, let's say, technological domains. And let's say, concept, our idea was to try to transfer these technologies to the one of the energy management in order to build really a building information modeling and to create a digital model for dealing with the energy into these industrial settlements, including of course plenty of characteristic and information such as temperature, humidity, pressure, air quality, the structure and the specificity of the walls, sails, roofs of the compartment of the buildings, and so on. Let's move on. Okay, we started by using this information to create, really, to build a methodology, which is this methodology that we're calling building energy management, which identifies the energy model of the building, including into this model, design, implementation, control, maintenance, and management facilities. Let's move on. Okay, here in this slide, we are introducing the concepts of BM and PM, and regarding the description of the methodologies here, we can say that the BM is used to estimate the energy consumption for thermal heating, mostly of the building, using a digital model that integrates buildings and process loads. The process loads are estimated with the PEM, process energy management, and as we can see, this is an important, let's say, component of the model, because the user processes are contributing a lot in terms of the energy used in the buildings. And together, these two methodologies, BEM and PM, are used to create a digital twin. This digital twin, which once validated, will allow to evaluate the effectiveness of energy efficiency solutions. Just a few words on the state of the art. Currently, there is to say that there is very little objective knowledge of the thermal behavior within industrial environments. A widespread and common methodology is not applied for the energy analysis of the building relating to the plants, and there is a lack of tools that makes an objective evaluation of the effectiveness of a building intervention solution in the industrial fields. As a solution, we propose the BM and P plus PM methodology to objectively evaluate the energy and economic savings of building improvements. Let's move on. Okay, here in this slide, we show the overall workflow of the BM plus PM methodology. In the first of three phases, one, two, and three, there is the steps of creating and running a first instance of the model with, let's say, a possible iteration for improving the model. In the steps four and five are basically the validation activities, and the one of analyzing and evaluating the possible intervention solution for the economic and energy savings. In the next slides, we mostly concentrate on the phase one, which is the one which is completed so far, and the other phase two is still running, and the other, especially four and five, are related to the next year of activities, as we will see. Okay, here you can see a detail of the phase one regarding the model and the input data, input information. The model area is, as I introduced, the Mira Fiori paint shop. It's a very large area of more than 80,000 square meters with significant process loads inside. On the central slide, there is this area identified in red, which is let's say collocated to the context of the large settlement of Mira Fiori, and it is characterized by different type of buildings. This slide, sorry, it is in Italian, but it's just to stating that there are close to the paint shop many other buildings. For instance, there is the assembly and body shop workshops. There are even some offices. There are some buildings for commercial facilities. There are also exhibitions area and so on. As a summary, on the left side of the slide, we have a list of the input data, which is the information necessary for the design and implementation of the partial BM model organized by topics. All data is real data, real information, recovered sometimes with some troubles and difficulties, but real data recorded at the facility. Okay, here we have an overview of the process of implementation of the partial model. This is the flow, as you can see from the top left to the bottom left of this picture. And there is an identification of the model area and the collocation of this area in the plant. There is the construction of the architectural 3D model. This model is exported with the component geometry and materials by means of a specific how to say interface layer, which is this GPXML file, in order to import this information where in the part of the digital twinning that allows to really carry out the energy analysis and the energy simulation, which is the design builder environment. And in addition to the DMM model, there is the detailing of the HVAC system, which is heating, ventilation, and air conditioning. And also this detailing is carried out within the design builder. Let's move to the next slide. Okay, here it's something which is interesting. We show just a summary of the geometric and thermostratigraphic information. There is a parametric 3D model implemented within Autodesk Revit, and the realization of the geometries and building components is starting from 2D and 3D CAD drawing supplied by the factory. And this modeling of the building is carried out on four different layers, reference levels of the paint shop area, and the attribution of the stratigraphies and thermal properties of the materials to the components of the building development has been carried out in terms of, let's say, materials and components of the walls, floors, roofs, and so on. And on the left side, you can see some nice 3D views of the exterior and interior part of the model. Okay, here there is some climatic and production data. It regards the additional information that are needed to run the energy simulation and to estimate the heating consumption of the building. And there is the hourly climatic file referring to the Turin area, and they are relating to the winter season from October 2018 to April 2019, with the details that I'm going to skip about external temperatures, humidity, solar radiation, wind speeds, and so on. And there is this is more important. There is the general scheduling of the production, which is provided by the plant production shifts, the production stops, the holidays, and so on. And here we have let's say, extrapolation, an analysis of this shift information, which is regarding the details of the scheduling in order to highlight the operation of the HVAC system. In particular, there are the measuring of the on and off operating set points for controlling the indoor temperature of the building. Okay, here we have the system information on the HVAC system. This system, so the heating, ventilation, and air conditioning, is modeled within Design Builder, and there is a plant division between the paint shop and the adjacent areas. So specific layout modeling with the identification of the various type of heating terminals. Let me not enter too much into some details. EHU means air handling unit, and PTAC means packaged terminal air conditioner. And here there is the modeling of the actual operation of each terminal, and this modeling is regarding, for instance, the thermal power, the on and off operation, and the terminal set points, and so on. Okay, here there is really the run of the energy, the first run we have carried out of our digital twin, and the simulation model is has been carried out, and it is presented here just in a summary. The first output of this simulation, which is obtained by using the partial model of the building without process load. So let me emphasize that it is also this phase is very, very preliminary. The simulation is obtained with the partial BEM model using Design Builder. Some simulation tests have been carried out to arrive at the final results, and Design Builder is providing different type of outputs, such as the internal temperature versus the external. In this picture, you can see that the indoor temperature reach the desired set points of that specific thermal zone. And there are the contribution of the energy thermal balance, and there are the air exchange rate. Let me move to the final slides. And here there is a comparison of the simulated with the real data. you can see there is a very, let's say, relevant, significant drift. Because in this comparison between a theoretical monthly and annual consumption has been carried out without taking in consideration the process loads, and it is in green, while in blue there is the real consumption supplied by the plant, and in red you see the difference, which is emphasizing the gap, which is not successfully, let's say, modeled into the current version, which is, let me say again, very preliminary of our model. In the phase two, so in the oncoming activities, the process loads will be estimated by including the process energy modeling into the partial BM. Which is this graphics in order to obtain a complete digital twin for the final. I have a couple of other slides to put on the light something which is very important that we are carrying out. So taking the opportunity of our work to make a comparison and a cross fertilization between the electronic component system in the industry and the automotive industry. Our analysis is not easily and directly, let's say, applicable as is to other domains. Building a digital twinning model at this level of complexity requires a very, very strong effort, as you can imagine. But it is important to emphasize that the possibility exist and are relevant indeed. Here, in fact, you see the commonalities, and we are working together with Patrizia and the colleagues from ST Microelectronics in order to make this cross fertilization. As you can see, there is on the left side an energy breakdown, the splitting in a typical manufacturing plant from ST, and the same is here from FCA. Let me not discuss too much about this because it takes time. There are similarities and differences, of course. This work of finding out mutual commonalities is including the strategies, the common strategies. Are the one of increasing the efficiencies of fabs, the increasing the system efficiencies and increasing, of course, the awareness of the energy saving approach. This work is ongoing, and we are very happy of this type of commonalities found, and we think that this common work will bring to useful and significant achievements for the benefit of both industries. That is the last slide of my presentation, which is regarding some future planned activities in the domain of Made in 4, which is this step, as I already said, which is ongoing, the inclusion of the process and energy. Modeling methodology in our model in order to make it much more precise and accurate into the representing the real consumptions. And as activity for the next year, we will do the achievement evaluation and validation. So the integration of the BM model with the PM data and the validation of the computer model. That's all from my side. I hope I took not too much of your time, and thank you again for the opportunity given to us to explain this and to describe this presentation. Bye.